Hello everybody, myself Prashant Mukhopadhyay, faculty member, Electrical Engineering Department, Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. In our last class of power electronics, we have started with the performance parameter of the chopper, and then we have started discussed about the classifications of the choppers, and from there we have discussed class A and the classifications like class A, class B, class C, class D, and class E choppers. And last of all, we have discussed class A chopper, which is a first quadrant chopper, and class B, which is a second quadrant chopper, and class C, which is a two quadrant chopper. And it is two quadrant is particularly first quadrant and second quadrant operations. It will be the combinations of class A and class B. But one most important thing we have discussed during the operations of the class A choppers, not the two choppers, chopper 1 and chopper 2 are operated simultaneously, rather they are operating one after another. Okay, so today actually we'll start a new chopper, so that is class D chopper. So this is actually the circuit diagram of the class D chopper. So it is also a two quadrant chopper. So this is the first quadrant and fourth quadrant chopper. So basically these are the this is chopper 1, this is chopper 2, and two diodes, diode 1 and diode 2, and this is load, RLD load. So basically actually here the main difference from the class C choppers is, so here both the choppers are operated simultaneously. So when both chopper 1 and chopper 2 are operated, so the, so these switches closed, basically they are the high pitch switch, so these are closed. So source voltage, actually input voltage will be due to input voltage, the load current will flow in like this. Okay, so the output voltage should be equal to this V. Okay. And when these choppers are off, so basically the energy stored in the inductor, so will be dissipated through this path. So this is back energy back to the source like this, in this way. Okay, but current are same, but output voltage will be negative here, so V output will be minus V. So that is described here. So it is both when chopper 1 and chopper 2 are triggered, simultaneously the output voltage is V0 equal to V, and output current flows to the load. And when chopper 1 and chopper 2 are turned off, the load current continues to flow in the same direction through D1 and D2, and due to energy stored in the inductor rail, and the output voltage V0 equal to minus V. In the average load voltage is positive if chopper on time is more than the off time. So in that case, if the chopper on time is more than the chopper off time, so average output voltage is positive, and average output voltage becomes negative if chopper on time is less than the chopper off time. So in the direction of the load current is always positive, and but the load voltage can be positive or negative. So this is the actually the waveforms. So this is actually gate pulse for the operating the thyristors of the chopper 1, and this is the gate pulse for operating the thyristors of the chopper 2. And you are seeing here both the pulses are given simultaneously. So in that case, both the choppers, chopper 1 and the chopper 2, will be operated in simultaneously, and this is the output current flow. When chopper 1 and chopper 2 will be turned off, so diode 1 and diode 2 will be conducting, and this is the output voltage will be negative of the input voltage, and this will be current will be dissipated, or energy will be back to the source or input like this. Okay, so D1 and this is conducting, and if turn on time is more than the turn off time, so this is actually when choppers are on, and this is actually when choppers are off, and diode 1 and diode 2 are conducting. Okay. So as a result, so this will be actually the output voltage wave power. And if you take into consideration, the average output voltage will be like this. It is more. So this is actually the conditions of say output waveforms. And if it is turn on time is less than the turn off time, then the average output voltage will be negative. So that everything will be same. That output current pattern and output voltage pattern will be different. Because turn off time is more here than turn on time. So this is actually class say D chopper. So once again I can repeat the entire discussion here. So like this, see, come here, this is class D chopper, this is the circuit diagram of class B chopper. So this is chopper class D chopper. So this is chopper 1, this is chopper 2, this is diode 1, this is diode 2, this is load, and this is the input voltage. So it is a 2 quadrant chopper. Here class D is a 2 quadrant chopper. This is here only current is always flowing to the load in the same direction, but output voltage for the 1 quadrant or first quadrant it will be positive, and for the 4th quadrant it will be negative. So as a result, when if we consider the operations on again, once again, when chopper 1 and chopper 2 are simultaneously on, that means this, since the choppers act like a high speed switch, so these are the, this part will be closed and this part will be closed, and then current will flow through the load in this direction, in this path. Okay, and in that case, the output voltage should be equal to this input voltage V. Okay, now. And current direction will be like this. So this is in this direction. So now when choppers are off, so this phase 1 and phase 2 are off, so in that case the energy stored in the inductor, so will change its polarity, and as a result, so current energy will back to the source through this path. So what we are finding here, so this is actually this current will flow in the same directions, but output voltage in that case will be of equal to minus V. So as a result, this output voltage is negative. Okay. So what we are finding here, so that is, if this during turn on time, if turn on time is more than the turn off time, then average output voltage will be positive. And if turn off time is more than the turn on time, then the average output voltage is negative. So that is actually being discussed and shown here. So actually I told you the class D is a 2 quadrant chopper. When both chopper 1 and chopper 2 are triggered simultaneously, the output voltage is equal to the input voltage V, and the output current flows to the load. When chopper 1 and chopper 2 are turned off, the load current continues to flow in the same direction through the load. D1 and D2, the diodes, due to the energy stored in the inductor L, and output voltage should be equal to the minus of V. And average load voltage is positive if chopper on time is more than the off time, and average output voltage becomes negative if turn on time is less than turn off. So hence the direction of the load current is always positive, but load voltage can be positive or negative. So these are, this is the say circuit diagram. So when turn on time is more than the turn off time, so this is the gate pulse for chopper 1, and this is the gate pulse for chopper 2. And we are seeing here that both the gate pulse are applied simultaneously, so both, as a result, chopper 1 and chopper 2 are on. So this is the load current. And when chopper 1 and chopper 2 are off simultaneously, diode 1 and diode 2 are conducting, and the energy stored through the inductor will be say allows the current to flow in the same direction through the load, and energy will be back to the input, and this and it is energy is being decreased or zero, so it will be current will flow. So like this, so this is the output current, and this is the output voltage waveform. So this is the chopper turn on time, and this is chopper turn on time. is more than the turn of time. So this is the output voltage waveform during chopper 1 and 2 on, and this is during since the output will be negative, and since the turn of time is less than the turn on time, so this is actually the output negative output voltage. So this is the output voltage profile, and as a result, so it continues. So this will be like this. So average voltage, output voltage will be positive. Okay. Now, actually, this is for when turn off time is more than the turn on time. So output current profile will be like changed, okay, and output voltage profile will also be changed, and the average output voltage will be negative. So that's actually clear your understanding about this class D operation, class D chopper and its operations, and hope you have understand it. If you what we are finding here, so basically we are seeing that like type C, type D is also two quadrant chopper, but basic difference is that in type C chopper, both the chopper actually is not operated simultaneously. It is, if it is operated simultaneously, circuit is like that, in that case short circuit will have to happen. But in class D, both the choppers are operated simultaneously. If you once again say remind our class C operational chopper circuit, so we'll find it. See, in class C, both cannot be operated simultaneously. So in that case, the input will be, if both are operated simultaneously, so this is a direct short circuit of this input. Okay, so that's why, so it is not operated simultaneously. Basically, actually like this, okay, or say like this. Chopper 1 and D2, and then chopper 2 and D1. Okay, see, that's we have discussed chopper 1 and D2 and chopper 2 and D1 conducts for the second quadrant operation, and this is for the first quadrant operation. But in if we say go to the circuit diagram of class D, basically, see here, both are operated simultaneously. If both are not operated simultaneously, it will not say conduct. Actually, this will be like this. Okay, this will be like this. And for when it is off, these two are off, so it will be like this. So it is back, and it is back. Okay, but current direction is same here. Clear. And that's why it is condition is same, voltage are for negative. But here, in case of class C, what we are finding here, for class C operation, current are not flowing in the same directions, basically. Voltage are in the same directions. Okay, so for first case, first quadrant operation, current in the positive directions, and for the second quadrant also current is in the negative directions. So but voltage is same, voltage is positive. Okay, but shift it is different. For class D, current directions are same. See, current directions are same in both the cases, but for first quadrant operation, both voltage and current are positive. And for second quadrant operation, current is output current is positive, but output voltage is negative. Okay, so whereas class C, it is first quadrant and second quadrant operation, so it can be the combinations of class A and class B. But here it is not. It is actually two quadrant operations, and it is class quadrant one and quadrant four. So this is the basic difference. So hope you have understand it, and you have it will clear that both are not same. Now we'll talk about class E chopper. So this is the circuit diagram of the class E choppers. Here we are using four choppers and four diodes. This is the load, RLE load, and this is the input voltage, input DC voltage basically. So actually this is a four quadrant operation. So actually this is for the when chopper one and chopper four on, this is class A operations, and when D2 and D3 conduct, so this is say four quadrant operation, four quadrants. And when this is so we'll come on how this four quadrant operations are going on. So basically in the first quadrant, chopper 1, chopper 4 on, and chopper 4 and D2 conducts. And for the second quadrant, chopper 2 and say D4 conducts, and D1 and D4 conducts, and chopper 3 and chopper 2 on for the third quadrant, and again chopper 2 and diode 4 conducts for the third quadrant. And for the fourth quadrant, diode 2 and diode 3 conducts, and chopper 4 and D2 conducts. So how it is happening? So we'll discuss one after another. So it is a four quadrant operations. So basically when chopper 1 and chopper 4 are triggered, output current I0 flows in the positive direction through chopper 1 and chopper 4 with output voltage V0 equal to the input voltage V. So how it is happening? So when chopper 1 and chopper 4 are triggered, this chopper 1 and chopper 4 are triggered. So what is happening? So this is the closed path in that case. So current is flowing in this way. So this is the current path. So what happening here? So this is the load actually. This will be equal to V0. Okay. So this is actually the output voltage V0. Okay. So you see the output voltage V0 equal to V. So this is the first quadrant operation. Why it is first quadrant operation? Because voltage is positive and current is also in the positive direction. See the directions once again. So this is the current directions, I0. Okay, and this is voltage. Clear? So as a result, so if you see here, chopper 1 and chopper 4, when it is on, so current is positive as well as voltage is positive, which is equal to the input voltage. So it is the first quadrant operation. Now when both chopper 1 and chopper 4 are off, the energy stored in the inductor L drives output current through D2 and D3 in the same direction, but output voltage V is equal to minus V. How? So let's see. So when chopper 1 and chopper 2 are off, so these two are off, chopper 1 and chopper 4 are off. So this is already energized, stored. So as a result, so when it is off, that means, so basically energy, it will change its polarity and it will be flowing like this. Okay. Here. So no, actually it is like this. Here, so in the same direction, but voltage will be negative for second quadrant operation. That is stated here. So when both chopper 1 and chopper 2 are off, the energy stored in the inductor L drives I0 through D2 and D3 in the same direction, but output voltage V is equal to minus V. D2 and D3. Once again, see. So it is actually like this. Path is like this. Okay, current direction is same, but actually this output voltage is equal to negative V. Clear? So that is actually what will happen in that case. So it is fourth quadrant operations. If you see here it is voltage is negative but current is the same direction, so it is fine. So this is actually fourth quadrant operations. Clear? Now when chopper 2 and chopper 3 are triggered, the load current I 0 flows in opposite direction and the output voltage Vg is equal to minus 1. So chopper 2 and chopper 3 are triggers. What will happen? See, chopper 2 and chopper 3. So these two are triggered. So what will happen? So when it is on, this is also on. So this is the path. Okay. Here. So actually, current direction is say negative, and so current directions in that case, chopper off, the energy stored in the inductor. No, this is actually when trigger the load current I0 flows in the opposite direction, the output voltage is Vg equal to minus V. So since both I0 and Vg are negative, the chopper operates in the third quadrant. Okay, so hit here it is. So these are on. So as a result, both I0 and this V0 are negative. So it is a third quadrant operation. Okay. Now, see what happened when both chopper 2 and chopper 3 are off, the load current I0 continues to flow in the same direction, and D1 and D4 and the output voltage V0 equal to V. So what will happen? Therefore, the chopper operates in the second quadrant as V0 is positive but I0 is negative. How it is? Both chopper 2 and chopper 3 of D1 and D2 are in conduction. See, chopper 2 and chopper 3 off. Chopper 2 and chopper 3 off. So in that case, what will happen? So this is actually the path. Okay. This is actually how it is like this. Okay, so see the operation here. See, when both chopper 2 and chopper 3 off, the load current I0 continues to flow in the same direction, D1 and D4, and the output voltage Vg is positive. Therefore, chopper operates in the second quadrant and Vg is positive but I0 is negative. D1 and D4. Okay, once again, see here. D1 and these are the off. These two are off. So, D1 and D4. Okay, current is flowing in the same direction, in the negative direction, in this direction. This will be like this actually. Okay, so we are getting see here, here. So this is the second quadrant operation. So here current is negative but voltage is positive, so it is second quadrant operation. See here. So therefore, chopper operates in the second quadrant. V0 is positive and I0 is negative. Okay, so that's all actually the class E operations actually. So once again, I am repeating this. So you will find, so when these are this is on. Okay. First quadrant operation, D2 and D3 when conducts, this is fourth quadrant operations. When chopper 3 and chopper 2 are on, so this is third quadrant operations, and in that case, so D1 and actually this will be like this. Okay, so once again, please look into the circuit. This is the circuit. First of all, we think chopper 1 and chopper 4 are on. What will happen? So this is the path. This is the path. Actually, I0 is positive and V0 equal to V, and that is also positive. This is first quadrant operation. So that is explained here. Chopper 1 and chopper 4 are triggered, output current either go in the positive direction to chopper 1 and chopper 4, and with output voltage be 0 equal to V. So this is first quadrant operation. Now when chopper 1 and chopper 4 are off, okay, see, these two are off, so energy here it is stored. So when it is off, so energy will be dissipated like this, okay, so D2 and D3 will be dissipated like this. So voltage will be negative, current will be positive, so it is a fourth quadrant operation. So when both these are off, the energy stored in the inductor L drives current to D2 and D3 in the same direction, but output voltage is visually equal to V, D2 and D3. Once again, see D2 and D3. So this is like this. No, this is like this. Okay. This is the part. So actually, in that case, this is a voltage is current in the same direction, voltage is negative, so it is a fourth quadrant operation. Okay, D23, isn't it like this? See, current in the same directions, but voltage is negative, so V0 equal to minus V. Clear now. This is actually a fourth quadrant operation. Now when chopper 2 and 3 are triggered, load current I0 flows in the opposite direction and output voltage V0 equal to minus V. So let's see, 2 and 3 are triggered. So this is 2 and this is 3. So what will happen? So if it is the case, so this will be like this. Okay, so I negative and I0 negative and V0 is also negative. So it is third quadrant operation, I think. Okay, I0 and V0 negative, so this operator is the third quadrant. Now, what will happen? Both chopper 2 and 3 are off. Load current I0 continues to flow in the same direction, D1 and D4, and the output voltage is equal to V. And therefore, the chopper operates in the second quadrant, V0 positive, but I0 equal to negative. So, when chopper 2 and 3 are off, see, 2 and 3, chopper 2 and 3 are off, these are off, 2 and 3. So, what will happen? This will be like this. Two and three are off. So this will be like is it so? Once again, see. 2, 3 off. So D1 and D4, the output voltage which is equal to B, this will be like this. Okay. So V0 is positive, but I0 is negative. So it is second quadrant operation. Okay. So this is actually second quadrant. V0 is positive, I0 is negative, so it is second quadrant operation. So that's all about this class E chopper. So this is actually fourth quadrant operation like this. I describe you. This is for the first quadrant operations. This is for second quadrant operations. This is for third, and this is for fourth. Okay. So hope you have understand this chopper circuits today, class D and class E choppers.